Some items you might think are hard to miss have disappeared, only to turn up at a nearby store. We're talking about statues that once stood outside the Christ the King Seminary. Those statues now guard the entrance of an antique store about 20 miles away. The iTeam's Olivia Broya looks at how the statues got there and why some say this is creating more distrust in the Diocese of Buffalo.
February 4th, 2020, the Buffalo Diocese announced Christ the King Seminary would close. In August, former seminary volunteers say statues around the property began disappearing. By November, volunteers say six bronze statues were completely gone, only to reappear at Kelly Schultz Antiques on Main Street in Clarence.
I jumped in my vehicle and I drove to the antique store in Clarence, which was a 60-mile round trip, and the statues were exhibited outside the building.
Kevin Brunn is an abuse survivor and a member of the Diocese Unsecured Creditors Committee, appointed by the United States trustee when the diocese filed for Chapter 11 bankruptcy last February. 7 Eyewitness News has confirmed with the antique shop the statues are indeed for sale, ranging in price from $4,000 to $9,000. Altogether, one could buy all six statues for $40,000.
I asked if they were for sale, and he said, yes, they are, and he quoted me the prices, and needless to say, I was taken back by that.
According to Christine Bartholomew, a professor at the University of Buffalo School of Law, the diocese must file a motion with bankruptcy court anytime they want to liquidate assets. The Unsecured Creditors Committee has the opportunity to respond. Then the judge can make a ruling.
The creditors committee would have an opportunity to weigh in on, one, should the sale happen, and two, in what manner should the sale occur?
7 Eyewitness News reviewed the court docket. As of February 18th, no motion has been filed regarding the sale of these statues. Steve Boyd represents some of the survivors on the Unsecured Creditors Committee.
I've appeared on every single hearing with Judge Buckeye, and none of this has been brought to the judge. None of it.
Bartholomew says this raises red flags.
You're in some ways saying, I want the benefit of bankruptcy, but I don't want to have the burden that comes with having to follow the judicial plan. And so at that point, the court has to figure out, well, do you get both? Do you get the benefit you're seeking if you're not willing to follow the rules?
After all, she says, the diocese has gone through the process of asking to sell assets before, just last summer.
The diocese is aware that they need to get permission for certain things, right?
So the diocese did this early on. They had a school down in the southern tier. They said, Judge, we want to sell this school. The creditors committee said, well, what's it worth? We want an independent appraisal. They ultimately didn't sell the school.
The diocese director of communications, Greg Tucker, told 7 Eyewitness News the statues were purchased by a woman for $3,000 apiece, a sale totaling $18,000. When asked about the sale to the antique shop, he said, quote, that means someone is either not giving me information or you have very bad information. Then, an hour later, Tucker said in an email to 7 Eyewitness News that Christ the King Seminary sold the statues to a local antique dealer several months ago, but he could not confirm an exact date. He says, quote, at the time of the sale, the seminary was not aware of the fact they had to get approval to sell property from the creditors committee. The statues were sold before the stipulation agreement was agreed to with the creditors committee. This is a copy of that stipulation agreement, which went into effect at the beginning of October. Tucker says these statues were sold for less than the threshold amount agreed to in the stipulation agreement, which is $25,000.
It gives the appearance of impropriety on another part of the diocese, and that appearance, in my opinion, is extremely inappropriate.
Boyd says this furthers his client's distrust in the diocese.
They still can't tell the truth. They're still trying to do backroom deals. They're still doing whatever they can to protect money when they never cared a bit about protecting the children. And that's the part that hurts the clients.
For the iTeam, Olivia Proya, 7 Eyewitness News.